After more than 50 years of supporting free trade, the US abruptly changed course in 2018. Starting in February of that year, import tariffs on over 12,000 products were increased from 2.6 to 16.6%. Of the over $300 billion of annual US imports affected, approximately $250 billion consisted of imports from China, and these actions, in turn, provoked a wave of retaliatory tariffs from the US's trade partners. Collectively, these retaliations increased average tariffs from 7.3 to 20.4% on roughly $125 billion of US exports. How did this trade war impact the US economy? Was it a net win or a net loss for the US? And how were those gains and losses distributed across different groups? In this paper, the authors tackle these questions and provide a comprehensive assessment of the trade war's effects. To start, what was the impact on US buyers of foreign imports? In general, tariffs drive a wedge between the price of foreign goods in their home market and the price paid by US buyers of those goods. Thus, the extent to which US buyers bear the cost of higher tariffs depends on whether those higher rates translate into higher prices for US buyers, or whether there is a compensating decline in the price of foreign exports. To gauge this trade-off in the context of the 2018 trade war, the authors estimate an economic model that incorporates patterns of demand for imported and domestic products in the US, as well as the supply of exports from foreign producers. Using the model to measure how US imports and foreign exports responded to the higher tariffs reveals that imports dropped sharply in response to the tariff increases. On average, the decline in imports of specific products targeted by US tariffs was 31.7%. Moreover, the authors find evidence of complete pass-through to US prices. This figure shows the results from an event study analysis and shows that before duty prices, that is, prices of foreign imports before including tariffs, were unaffected by the enactment of higher tariffs. In contrast, there was an immediate increase in duty-inclusive prices. This indicates that the US economy bore the cost of these higher tariffs, as they were completely passed through in the form of higher prices paid by US buyers. The aggregate hit to US consumers and firms who buy imports totaled $51 billion, or 0.27% of GDP. But tallying the impact on US buyers of foreign imports is only one piece of understanding the effects of the trade war. We also need to account for the impact on US producers, who potentially benefit if higher tariffs induce US consumers to buy domestic goods rather than foreign ones, but who also bear the cost of the retaliatory tariffs imposed by US trade partners. The authors estimate that these countermeasures resulted in a 9.9% decline in US exports of targeted products. Thus, the authors incorporate the supply side of the US economy into their model and estimate producer gains of $9.4 billion, or 0.05% of GDP. Aggregating these producer gains with the previously estimated loss to US consumers of $51 billion, and further adding the $34.3 billion in tariff revenue collected by the US government, yields a total loss to the US economy of $7.2 billion, or 0.04% of GDP. Building this aggregate number by separately estimating its constituent parts illustrates how different parts of the economy were affected differently by the trade war, and also makes clear that while there was only a small net loss for the economy as a whole, US consumers of foreign goods paid a heavy cost. The results point to a substantial redistribution from US consumers to US producers and the government. Finally, the authors also investigate the spatial pattern of gains and losses from the trade war. First, they show there is a clear contrast between the regional pattern of counties who benefited the most from increased import protection and those who were hit the hardest by the retaliations. This figure shows that the benefits from higher tariff protection were concentrated in the Great Lakes region of the Midwest and in the industrial areas of the Northeast. While this figure shows that rural regions of the Midwestern Plains and Mountain West were hit hardest by the retaliatory tariffs. Probing further, the authors show that tariff protection was highest for products made in electorally competitive counties. In other words, counties with a 40 to 60% Republican vote share in the 2016 presidential election received more protection than heavily Republican or heavily Democratic counties. In contrast, U.S. trading partners retaliated by targeting sectors in heavily Republican counties. Combining these two patterns, the author's model suggests that workers in heavily Republican counties bore the largest cost of the trade war, and that losses in those areas were 32% larger than those in heavily Democratic counties. In conclusion, this paper finds that while the estimated impact of the 2018 trade war on the U.S. economy was relatively limited at a loss of only $7.2 billion, that aggregate number hides notable distributional effects. Not only was there substantial redistribution from U.S. consumers to producers and the government, the spatial patterns indicate that heavily Republican counties experienced the largest losses. Looking ahead, the authors emphasize that these results speak only to the short-run impacts of the trade war, and that an examination of the long-run effects are an important topic for future work. As always, to delve deeper into this topic, you can check out the full paper and its references to other related research. These include papers studying the impacts of changes in trade costs or foreign shocks, many papers focusing more specifically on trade policy, including tariffs, and finally, a growing body of work on the 2018 trade war.